Hello YouTube, welcome by a new computer vlog. It's almost a month ago that I uploaded my last video because I was on holiday. I went 18 days to Suriname and after that I was quite busy with work and all kinds of late shifts, so I didn't have the time to shoot a video. So let's make a video. I'm using the 1998 Dreambuild to make the first retro machine shareware floppy. The shareware floppy is the reward for supporting me on Patreon. So if you like to get one, you can check out my Patreon page. The first edition has two games, but I don't gonna tell which ones because that will spoil the surprise for my Patreon supporters. The games are two favorites from my childhood. While I was on holiday in Suriname, my uncle found a nice system. So let's check it out in this video. Here we have it. The system looks like an ATX MIDI tower, but when we check the back, we can see that there's an AT motherboard inside. So this case is an AT/ATX hybrid case. So let's check it out in this video. Oh shit, the studio's a big mess and I use my studio table to sort out my clothes for the holiday and all kinds of stuff on the floor, so I think I need to clean it up a bit before I can shoot this video. Let's put the camera on my tripod. Let's fix this mess. So, that's better. So let's check out this AT/ATX hybrid computer case. Here on the case badge it says HiPack, and I never heard about that brand. So it's probably a cheap clone build and they were thinking, oh, let's copy the name of Compaq because it maybe sells more computers. Here we have the Intel Inside Pentium MMX case badge and it's designed for Windows 95. Here we have the power button and it's an old style AT power button. Here you have the reset switch and another switch. And I think if you use it as an ATX case, you can use this switch to power on the system. It has no drives installed but comes with two drive bay covers and they are made out of metal. The design of this case is pretty nice and clean, but what did they do here? They really fucked it up with this ugly plastic blue piece of shit. I really don't like this part of the design. Here on the back we see there's some power supply installed and we have 7 spots for expansion cards here. Instead of an ATX I/O shield, they installed an AT I/O shield. So with a DIN keyboard plug, and here we have spots for the parallel and serial ports. So that's pretty nice. Here we have a sticker with some specification and the system is assembled in Germany. The model is an HQXD MIDI 166M, so it's probably a Pentium 166 MMX. 16 is probably the memory, 2 is probably the hard drive. I don't know if it's installed. There were 24 speed CD-ROM installed, a hard drive 3.5 inch, 2 gigabyte. Here on the side panel there's a big warning sticker
and it says, in order to provide for a proper radio interference elimination, it must be taken care that the contact mechanism between the individual parts of the casing is not damaged while opening or closing the casing. Apart from that, the correct fitting of the casing must be checked after mounting.
To open the case we must move this handle first to the back and then down. What a mess inside this case. There's no hard drive in the system, but there's still a motherboard with memory and a CPU and a CPU cooler inside. And a big pile of cables. Here we have an IDE cable, another IDE cable, a floppy cable, a parallel port, a serial port with an extreme long cable, so that always comes in handy. Oh, we also have the manual of the motherboard, in German of course. And the brand of the motherboard is Atrent and it's an ATC1020+. All the cables are removed from the motherboard and the motherboard has an Intel VX chipset, 3 ISA slots, 4 PCI slots, and I think there's more memory installed than 60 megabytes because they are using 2 kinds of memory sticks. And we have the CPU cooler with a little bit of dust with CPU under it. And I don't see any broken capacitors. So that's nice. Let's check if the motherboard and the power supply is still working. So we're gonna install this Diamond Stell 3D 2000 Pro as a video card. And I will connect the cables again. If you're connecting AT power cables on the motherboard, make sure the black cables are in the middle. Okay, Pentium 166 MMX with 32 megabytes of memory. CMOS checksum error, probably the battery is empty. Keyboard is also working and we have 512 kilobytes of cache. This combination of motherboard with the memory and the CPU is perfect for an MS-DOS time machine. So that's a really nice find. I don't need a motherboard like this in an AT/ATX hybrid case, so I'm gonna take it apart. Nice, a Seasonic 150 watt power supply. It's pretty rare to find an AT power supply which has a real brand on it. So here you have it, an ATX/AT hybrid case. So what is it and how does it work? An ATX/AT hybrid case is pretty simple. It's a case that can support an ATX motherboard, but also an AT motherboard. If we start with the power supply, we can see that the holes for the mounting are the same for the AT and the ATX power supplies. So you can simply swap out the power supply for the power supply you need for the system. The power button that's now installed is an AT power button. And behind this power button there is the switching of the high voltage, so the 220 of the 110 volt. Here we have the two buttons, one reset button and probably one power button. But it says reset switch on both cables. But you can use one of those to power the ATX motherboard. So here you have the I.O. shields. The white one is an ATX I.O. shield which just clicks in the back of the system. And that's pretty standard. But this AT I.O. shield fits in the spot of the ATX I.O. shield. But it has the AT keyboard plug and the COM ports and the parallel ports. The way how they designed this I.O. shield is that it slides in here, so it's not compatible with any ATX case. I rather see the I.O. shield system like this that you just push in, because this ATX I.O. shield fits in every case, even in modern cases. You can probably buy AT I.O. shields on eBay, so make sure that it fits your case, because this one doesn't fit all cases. Here we have the motherboard tray, and this motherboard tray supports both ATX and AT motherboards. Here you have the motherboard standoffs, and you can simply slide them out here and put them on another position if you use an ATX board. To make sure your AT boards will fit your ATX tower, you need to have standoffs on this line, and you can check that by the placing of the I.O. shields. So in the middle of the I.O. shields, you need standoffs on these spots. Or you need to use plastic stands like this, or the rubber feet like this under your motherboard. So to mount the AT motherboard in this case, you need the standoffs on these spots. and here by the memory and the ISA slots. Here you can see that this case also supports ATX motherboards, but you need to remove this stand off and this stand off and install them on the spots here and here. But this motherboard is pretty long, so there are no options for stand offs in this line. So if you want to install an ATX motherboard, you can better install a smaller size one. I hope that you now have a better understanding what an ATX/AT hybrid case is, and that an AT motherboard can fit in an ATX case, but only if the motherboard stand offs are in the right position. And if your case doesn't have the right motherboard stand offs, you need to buy the plastic stand offs that are sticky, so you can still mount the motherboard into your more modern case. The other tricky part is a power button, so maybe you need to do a little case mod to mount a power button, but this case supports both methods of the power button. So thanks for watching, please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook. If you like to have a Retro Machine shareware floppy, then you can support me on Patreon. And all the links to the Patreon page and the Facebook group are in the description.
The time is 8:47 a.m. Current topside temperature is 93 degrees, with an estimated high of 105. The Black Mesa compound is maintained at a pleasant 68 degrees at all times.